Over the past two decades, the oyster population in Mississippi's Gulf waters has been devastated by natural and man-made disasters, including Hurricane Katrina and the Deepwater Horizon oil spill. Among those working to restore oyster habitats, called oyster reefs, is a ninth grader named Demi Johnson. The National Geographic Society recently recognized her work over the past 2 years, growing more than 1,000 oysters. And those oysters are likely to spawn millions more in the years to come. Recently, I spoke with Demi and asked her what goes into an oyster farm.
First, you obviously need oysters, and you need a pier to do it off of, and you need cages, and you need to be able to do weekly maintenance on these oysters.
What does it take to sort of raise oysters? I mean, you don't plant them. You don't put them in the ground like seeds. How does it work?
So you're going to put oysters in a cage, and then you're going to have a rope, and you're going to tie it to the outside part of a pier. And naturally, if you were to drop these cages in while they're tied up, they're going to be just kind of in the water. Honestly, when it comes to like maintaining or taking care of, once a week is fine, just to shake the cages and to get the critters out, because they are seen as a food source to other animals. Once I'm done with the oyster gardening, they are dumped out into another area, and they start to become their own reef.
How did you get started in this? How did you get interested in it?
So I found out about this through my Girl Scout troop, specifically from my Girl Scout leader. So there's a thing called a silver award, and you have to do a project for your community, something community-based. And she just kind of put it up in the air. She was like, hey, you can do oyster gardening at my pier. And I was like, okay, I'll do it. Like, it doesn't sound too bad. And, you know, it's just something easy for me to do.
And then a researcher at Auburn University found out about you, I understand, and has actually become a mentor. What have you gotten out of working with her?
I've gotten a bunch of information about oyster gardening. So when I first started oyster gardening or starting this project, I had no clue about this. I only thought oysters could be eaten. I didn't know they could be used for restoration. So I was able to learn a lot through her, and she was able to keep in contact with me, and I've been able to learn more and more, and more opportunities have been given to me.
When this began, you really had no idea about this, and you've learned a lot. What's the coolest thing you've learned?
I think the coolest thing I've learned is that oysters actually serve as a filter in the water. I did not know that. And they actually can serve as a home to over 300 species in the water. So that's just super cool.
How does it make you feel that you're teaching people about this?
I think it's really cool because I went from having little to no background about this topic to knowing a lot more than I did. So I just think that's like super cool, and I'm happy that people get to learn more.
Where does this project go from here?
Well, in September, oyster season will be starting, and I'm going to go from 5 cages like I did last season to 9 cages, so just expanding.
Has this affected what you think you might want to study in college and maybe what you want to do as a career?
Yes, so I want to attend University of Michigan, and specifically I want to major in environmental law. And once I'm done with that career-wise, I want to represent environmental groups.
Demi Johnson, oyster farmer. Thank you very much.